that the evaluation will start. And we are almost coming to the end of second academic year. It's hardly 4 months. And you will have to do a project. And you will have to do a course examination for 2 subjects. This semester will be comparatively lighter if you look at the number of lectures. But at the same time, it's challenging because you have to do a project. So today's briefing will be more about project work. Radha sir will tell you something about. Then we will get a feedback from you. And finally, say something, because we already have discussed about. I got the feedback which you had already submitted to Radha sir. Then we had a discussion on that. So there will be some new guidelines and some changes which Radha sir will tell you. In the meanwhile, Priya madam also will join. And then we will have a discussion. Give you some more time, say a week's time, to decide about your project work. And by the time next week when you come, we will finalize the whole thing. How to go on.
Okay, madam. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Welcome back to school. Welcome back to college. Nahi. Welcome back to university. I hope you had a good break in between. I know most of you were in touch with each other. I was also able to meet some of them. But I think post-exam, it's almost after 2 and a half weeks that we are meeting up. It's exactly 2 weeks. So on Mumbai is that I think 3/4 of the course is over. That means 3 semesters over. And being the first batch, I'm sure many of you must be going through a lot of कैसे होगा क्या होगा पेपर कैसे होगा व्हाट इज द पैटर्न ऑफ दोस थिंग्स एंड आई एम श्योर दैट यू कंटिन्यू फॉर द फोर्थ टर्म आल्सो बट लेट मी पुट द अदर वे अराउंड इज दैट टिल नाउ वी हैव बीन ऑल ऑफ अस सक्सेसफुली एबल टू लुक एट 2 पार्ट्स व्हिच इज ईयर नंबर 1 7172 राइट सो लेट मी गो बैक एंड आस्क एवरीबॉडी गॉट योर मार्कशीट्स दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग बिकॉज द एग्जाम दैट यू गिव यूजुअली यू गेट सेमेस्टर टू सेमेस्टर बट देन फाइनली 7172 का मिल गया ना सबको. So I hope everybody has collected it. Make sure you have a copy of it for yourself. Don't be dependent on us. Scan it, email it to yourself. Because we have seen students coming here after years and struggling for the mark sheets, convocation certificate and all those things. Okay, abroad jaane ke baad yaad aata hai ki wo certificate dena padta hai. So please keep your paperwork intact from year one for this particular course at least.
At no cost lose your mark sheet. At no cost. Because it would be terrible to get a duplicate in the university. Especially for us, it is very difficult because we are a self-finance course which the other university people are taking as autonomous. Good for us that they are treating as autonomous. But autonomous, it means that if you go to them with a request that we have lost our mark sheet, it will be a very painful experience for you. Yes. So, as he suggested, that you email it to yourself, a scan copy, and preserve it very well.
Yeah. So, it's very important that all of you have mark sheets. Huh? Sabka mila na? There were one or two cases jahan aapko spelling mistake hona tha. But kya ho gaya sort of? Please be in touch with me. That's not a major thing. What about you? So please be in touch. That's not something to worry. But please follow up at your end. See what happens, Vinod will follow up at his end, but you follow up Vinod. But I don't want after 3 months and sir, pehle mila nahi. Because all this will count. So except for two of them, anybody else? ठीक है? So घर पे कहाँ पे रखा है? I hope everybody knows about it. Scan करो, mail करो. I'm also requesting, if possible, we don't have to keep a copy of Xerox for all of us. Okay, once he comes in, because as a record, we will get started. So I'll take care of that. At individual level, please keep it a record. Best is to keep it soft copy. So I think administratively, before we go to SEM 3 and 4, SEM 1 mein kuch bhi baki hai. I know fees has been paid, everything has been done at all level, but anything pending over you? So now, कुछ बाकी नहीं हमारे तरफ से आ रहा है. We go to SEM 3. और SEM 3 का एग्जाम सब टॉप
होगा. SEM 3 some students
still not paid. I'll come to that. So SEM 1 and 2 done. Clear? We go to SEM 3. Examinations have been done, but a few students have yet to pay the fees. So let us know one to one what is to be done. Rather than that, examination assignments सब हो गए हैं. Okay, so we are now in the other process. You'll get your mark sheets around later on. But now, officially from 11th of this particular month, that is 11th of January, the next semester starts. That means for all of you, the fourth semester starts. So what we're going to discuss today, Saturday, which is 13, your actual semester has started. So today's meeting, for all of you, will have a few agenda. So number one agenda is basically we'll be discussing the timetable. So something written. We are not going to discuss next week's timetable or day after. We are going to plan out the whole semester for you. So right from what's going to happen in Jan, Feb, March, April. Okay, so your examination would be tentative in April. Why am I again tentative in April is because university will tell us when to conduct the exam. It's not going to happen. And a lot of students, last time also, first semester, second semester, third semester, sir, exam ka aap se aapko bata deta hu, but again with the catch that this is tentative, but at least it will help you in macro planning. I know most of you are traveling, some of you have very busy schedules, but then we are going to give you an overall thing about the timetable. Second is projects. I think that's a major discussion that will have in detail. The third, for me, the most important thing is address of madam, because the projects that you are going to do is almost going to be like a mini PhD for all. Okay. So what she's going to guide is not only for your fourth semester student, but basically the way she guides all of her PhD students, which included me. So you'll get a fair idea. It is not going to be a PhD, but it is going to prepare you for your PhD for all the students who are interested. So we had a thorough meeting, lot of brainstorming internally with each of your students, what the topics you are given. All of you are given these topics, right? So we'll discuss that in detail. That's the major thing. And I've been seeing that a lot of students are also worried about it. So don't worry about it. Think about it. Plan it out and we are here to support you. But the thing is that you have to put a lot of effort about it. Be serious and sincere about your projects. And that's where Madam will guide us, you know, about the whole project part. After that, I will be spending some special time with the research students. So just for, there are a few people who are supposed to join the batch 2. But we have tell them, you know, batch 2 will now start only next week, but they are also doing some research work, so I will address you separately. The reason why we have called you to be part of this meeting is that you will understand how the research projects are done, so you can also take some cues in. Okay. That will sit separately after this batch. Other thing, we are here to spend some time with you individually. So if there are fees ka hai, kuch aur hai. So this is the overall agenda. Anything else you want other than this agenda? Because most of the things that we want to cover is covered, but anything else? Okay, so overall, take care. So let's start with the first one.
Get
okay, so what we will do is that we will move on to this agenda. We'll spend around, as I told you, 12:30 maximum 1 o'clock, depending on what your Q&A is. But today there is no classes, okay? Tomorrow also there is no classes. All this will tell you, it will start from next week. Today is just a briefing session. So let me start with the timetable. Okay, so if you look at this timetable, we have broadly made up a Jan, Feb, March, April. Again. All these are basically tentative. Everything will get filled up. Don't expect us to fill it in right away, but at least we are giving the macro picture. If you look at all these things, the dates that we have written is weekend date, Saturday, Sunday, right? So today if you look at it, today is 13th of January. Last week we did not have anything. So today we have called you for a briefing, but no lectures. Tomorrow there is nothing. Okay. Now what we have done is that 20, 21 is next Saturday, Sunday, 27, 28 of Jan. then February you see, March you see, April you see. Okay? Now, if you look at it, mota-mota, hum log ko kya-kya karne hai. Okay? And then we'll see where to plug it in. You have two more papers to give. Correct? Are you aware of it? Last time it was 5 papers. This time it becomes 2 papers. But 100 marks ka project diya. So this semester is basically going to be 300 marks. First semester mein kitna tha? 400. Second semester mein? 400. Third semester mein? 500. And now it is 300. Overall it is going to be 1600. That's the total, 1600. So out of 1600, 1300 is over. And now we have two, which is basically theoretical classes bhi hoga uska and 100 marks for project. Once we get the syllabus, we'll discuss that. We'll go in that detail. But just to tell you, the way we have said is that project is going to be a very important part of it. So we'll discuss how the project is going to be done. Interestingly, we are going to keep this week, or rather this semester, maximum possible, no lectures on Saturdays. Okay? The reason is that you can focus on your projects during that time. And some of you are also able to work with the projects along with Saturdays, and it would be better for us. Maximum possible. Your lectures we are scheduling on Sundays only. And we have seen this pattern that Sundays go, the attendance is also more because some of you work and all that, right? So maximum lectures would be on Sundays. And uske baad apne ko two more things we'll be doing. There's a Delhi visit, right? So we have scheduled the Delhi visit tentatively around 24-25. Now this is tentative date. Now we may go for a 5-day or a 7-day trip that we will see. So it is not that 24-25. This will be tentative. It could be the week before that or a week after that. There's a lot of process we have to do. The approvals, financials and all those things. So let me start with the month of Jan. So Jan, dekhoge 13th we are there, tomorrow nothing. But before next week, we'll tell you what is going to happen on 24th. As of now, there is no lectures on Saturday. Fifth, 28th, all those things. So we have kept it only lectures for the month of Jan. What is interesting is that, and then thanks to Madam, that we are actually creating a kind of a mini revolution. Because with the Arthashastra courses that we are doing, there are a lot of colleges within Bombay who are now doing Arthashastra seminars and lectures. Okay? So, SIS College, all of you know SIS, not about health and science. We have Dr. Uma Sankar, she is also part of the Department of Philosophy, she is a principal there. So, she said, you know, we want to hold a 2-day Arthashastra seminar. Okay? Now, this seminar is fixed, it's going to be happening on 9th and 10th. It's a Friday, Saturday, not a Saturday, Saturday. It's fixed without us also.
Friday,
9th and 10th of February. Okay. Any student who wants to be part of the seminar and want to present a paper, you can also do that. Okay. Now, if you remember, all of you did the ICPR's program. So all of you, it's a part of it. Some of the students prepared full paper and they could not get an opportunity. And as Madam told that we will have a seminar internally. But here is a other opportunity. If you want to do a full-fledged seminar with other people also attending, so I would request Chetan, I will pass on the details to everybody, but I will give a coordinator teacher at SIS College, her name is Kamala. She requires full papers, okay? Not just ki mereko attend karna. Two ways you can attend that seminar. Number one, you can be part of it as a student attending, and you should. Okay, you should, because 10th ko toh at least up. But if you want to attend it as a presenter, where you want to say paper presentation, it's going to be a very, like, you know, if you do your PhD, you have to present papers in seminars, national, international, as a both that. So this can be the certificate will have its own value if you present it. So that dates are 9th and 10th. I will pass on the details to you. Go as an attendee or go as a paper presenter. If you want to do that, Madam is Kamala Madam. I will give you the contact detail. Whoever are interested, please tell him. And then you have to write down the paper. You've already done it, but in that format and give it to her, I think before 15th or 16th, aisa kuch hai. Okay, let me get back. So talk to her. Now that also becomes a part of your course, so that you can see Rathya Shastra.
So 15th or 16th of this month?
February.
9th, 10th to...
No, if you can get to this one, you have to submit the paper.
Paper you have to submit the 9th, 15th, 16th.
15th तक होता है, because already if you are ready with your paper, so you just refine it and send it, right? तो उनको टॉपिक देना है फुल पेपर देना है, आप उनसे बात करो बट आपको एक दो दिन पहले एक्स्ट्रा चाहिए तो मान लेना, बट इट कांट बी लाइक यू नो लास्ट मोमेंट तक रखो. तो दैट्स देयर डेडलाइन. बट आई सेड हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू गो एंड हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू प्रेजेंट, दैट्स योर चॉइस, बट प्लीज गो. दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू एक्चुअली गो देयर. And they are planning to call all people like, you know, Chandraprakash Divedi, some scholars and all those things. So of course, we will also be there. But the thing is that it's not organized by us. So you will not have the tension of being an organizer and attendee. Okay, so how many of you want to present as a talk? Or we refine them, no? Get in touch with them. I'll give you the details before we leave today. Okay? So be in touch with Chetan Kaur. Other thing is that there is one Hiradia College. How many of you are aware of it? They said, we want to host an Arthashastra seminar for their students in their college. And say, you conduct it. So, Mera and Madam ka baat was saying that the best part of it is that we can repeat ICPR without being the organizing person. So, ICPR, we had all of our students and teachers and people, right? So, we still have to work out. So, what we are saying is that we will try to do a two-day seminar where our students will be presenting. Again, you can present the same thing. But what is happening, that we'll have to discuss, this will come. And what we are doing is that, for us, if it's an SIA seminar, all of you take it very seriously, then we will move this to the next month. So you see, then what we are technically doing is that we still have a police station visit. So it's not a police station, actually it's a study of the police administration and leadership. And unka Saturday ko hi ho sakta hai, because you want to see those. So there are senior IPS officers who are happy to take a student and go through a complete, you know, briefing of how the police administration works. So what we are saying is that either we do it on 17th of Feb or we do it on 17th of March, which is again Saturday, right? Agar ye yahan pe police department visit hota hai, then we should Hiradia College ka Arthashastra seminar on the next one. If you are not interested in SIS, then we can hold it here. You get my point? Either or. So, I hope all of you will be able to go for SIS seminar then, yes. On Saturday at least, and paper presentation. Then what we do, we will move this Hiradia thing to the next month, so that all of you get chance to prepare again. And if you can prepare something new and better, that would be better. Then what we do, on 17th, we have the police department visit. Again, February. And then, of course, tentatively Delhi visit. We already spoken to a few ministers and things like that. But the whole idea is basically, उसका प्लानिंग हम आपको बाद में देंगे. बट दिस आर द टेंटेटिव डेट्स. देन वी गो टू मार्च. गुड मॉर्निंग. मार्च अगेन मैक्सिमम संडेज को लेक्चर्स एंड प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑन द अदर डेज. पुलिस स्टेशन ओके. वी आल्सो वी ऑलरेडी लुक एट द कैलेंडर्स. ऑन 18th ऑफ मार्च वी हैव गुडी पाटा, राइट? सो नो लेक्चर्स ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर डे. सो मेनी पीपल से यू नो घर पर रहना, इट्स नो विद योर फैमिली. एंड 25th ऑफ मार्च वी हैव द रामनवमी. So that's again a holiday. And then, if you look at it, 1st April is Easter. We are waiting for the university to communicate to us when will the actual exams be. It could be here also, it could be here also, we don't know. But the way you look at it is that, Jan, Feb, March, ye 3 mahine ka aapka semester hoga. Clear? Now I'll go to the lecture part of it. Now for us, we need to achieve 3 things, lectures, projects and field visits. Projects, lectures and field visits. And the 4th thing which we have included as a part of its continuation of the Arthashastra seminars. Aap log na ICPR seminar kiya tha na. But the good part is there's a lot of demand also. As I told you, that's good, so we get involved in that. So this SIS college and the Hiradia college thing is an add-on to us. But let's do that also. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. So let's discuss on the first part of it, which is basically the lectures. So let's go back to semester 3 and semester 4. I hope everybody has got a copy of this. You can refer to this later on. Like in semester 3, in semester 4, we have 2 groups. Correct? And 2 groups is group number 1 is interdisciplinary and the 2nd is skill-based development. Now in interdisciplinary, you have choices 1, 2, 3, 4. We have decided that there will be our teacher Nutan Madam, all of you remember?
Yes.
She will be taking one of them. And then we have skill based development, we have decided Indian Communication Design by Dr. Sanjay Ranade. This will be our two teachers. I'll repeat it for you. The first one, group one, will be selecting
first paper,
logical reasoning.
There is another paper, symbolic logic.
Yeah.
But that will not be taught.
So in that four option, yeah, logical reasoning will be taken by Dr. Nutan. And the other one, in group number two, we have C, which is Indian Communication Design, will be taken by Dr. Sanjay Ranade. According to the pattern, we require 12 lectures in every semester. So you will have 24 lectures combined together. What is happening is that if you come on a Sunday, depending on the teacher's availability, they can take one or two lectures. Like how Seema Madam used to take two lectures at a stretch. So technically speaking, if the teacher decide to take two lectures every Saturday, Sunday, and you come on a Sunday and you have four lectures, so in 6 weeks actually it should be over. Get my point? But that means 1.5 months may be ho sakta hai. But that freedom we are going to leave it to the teachers and their availability also. So what is happening is that we may not have the lectures. We may even decide to finish off the lectures faster. But that's not the idea. The idea is that we'll have more time to spend on the projects. Okay? So, two papers, 12 lectures, spread over number of Sundays that they decide. Like for example, tomorrow why we are having a holiday is because Nutan Mom is not well. So she said, you know, I'll take it from next Sunday. So next Sunday ka definitely. And next Sunday means 21st. 21st you are having a lecture with Nutan Ma'am, and probably with Sanjay Sir's availability, we'll also have that. So when Shefali has been coordinating with them, we'll tell you the exact time and everything, but your time remains the same, which is 9 to 5.30. Which may be flexibility depending on the teachers. Clear on the lecture part of it? What you can do is that later on, you can go through the details of these papers that is already there in the syllabus, right? Clear? Now, usme dekh lijiye the teachers. The good part is that these teachers themselves have actually created the syllabus. Like Seema ma'am. So this time Sanjay Ranade sir, unka hi pura frame kiya syllabus. So it becomes very easy for them also. Now, we will also be there. So don't think that hum nahi rahenge. So we'll be there. But you have to understand that these people are experts in their field. So ma'am will be there and there, Priya ma'am will be there. So for all practical reasons, three of us being part of the board of studies will always be there with you wherever you require guidance, extra lectures will be there. This happened last time, pre-LM, we want an extra lecture briefing. All these will be there. But technical experts for these two papers will be Nutan Madam and Sanjay Ranade sir. Any questions in that? Clear? Okay. Now we come to the most important part, this projects. Okay? In other words, lots and lots of debates, discussions, and one thing we want to tell you that probably there is a lack of clarity which we will give you. What is a project? 100 marks ka project hai? Correct? 100 marks ke project mein, we had asked you to give what topic you want to do a project. There is a little bit of a gap in what probably a project is and what we have understood, and that's where we will require an expert opinion of madam to actually brief you. But before that, let me give you a little bit of idea of what we discuss and what should be the framework. And then madam will give some guidelines. Number one, very important, as madam told you, it's almost like a mini PhD. Now what is a mini PhD? There is a research method to it. There is a, you know, when we do PhD, there's something called as coursework. There's a research methodology to it. And then there is lot of research which is actually happening. It will be data collection, going, reading, all those things. And finally, the output has to be in a return format. Okay? The output has to be in a return format. Your research, okay, you will have to write something called as a dissertation. I don't know whether you'll be calling it a dissertation in this sense. It will be called a project work, but it has to be in a return format. What we will do is that we'll help you to understand all this process, especially from an academic standpoint. But as you know, ma'am always rightly points it out, let us understand the overall objective of the projects, irrespective of which topic you are taking. The overall objective of all the projects that you are taking up for 100 marks, each one of you, is application of Arthashastra or any of the subjects that you learn in those respective projects. I'll repeat it. Understand this philosophically first. हमने जो सीखा है डेढ़ साल में उसका एप्लीकेशन होना चाहिए. एप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्राइमरली वी आर सीइंग कौटिल्य अर्थशास्त्र, बट देन यू सी वी नॉट ओनली लर्न कौटिल्य अर्थशास्त्र, वी लर्न सम एंशिएंट इंडियन मॉडल्स, वी लर्न डिसीजन मेकिंग साइंस, वी लर्न पॉलिटिकल साइंस, वॉट एवर इट इज. यू हैव टू चूज वॉट एवर इट इज यू आर लर्न थियोरेटिकली एंड यू टू अप्लाई, एंड फाइनली in that output jo aayega we will be doing a publication of it. So that's where the written format is important. Okay, now we'll come back to what all of you have done. Now here is the interesting part of it. Lot of us did not have a clarity and we could not get connected to it also, but let me tell you that all three of us will guide you in this process later on. But the fact is that this doesn't look like a project, and therefore we are going to give you the freedom to change the topic also. Okay, and we have two things to do. Number one, and that could be something interesting, you can use the theoretical knowledge that you learned, number one, in your own organizations or somewhere else that you believe in. For example, if somebody like Ambarish, I'll just give an example, or somebody like Rajesh, or anybody who is running a company, an organization, can use the whole thing in your organization and say ki I have applied chanakya arthashastra or decision making science and this is my output. So it gives you that freedom, but the thing is that how to do it, that is something we'll guide you one to one. Second important thing, it is not necessary that you have to apply that only in your organization. He can apply it or she can apply it, like machine can tell ki main dekhti hu kaise HR apply karte, but then you can also apply it somewhere else. Getting a point, so we have two categories here. Those people are already in some particular company, organization, project. उसे भी apply करके देखो. Does अर्थशास्त्र or the theory work? Vice versa. I don't want to apply in my company. I have to apply it somewhere else. Maybe in my community. Maybe I have to apply in my NGO. Maybe I have to apply it wherever you want. So what we will be doing is that application of the theory to practice is your project. Is your project. What is the topic? You can decide. Which area? You can decide. We'll discuss this. But for that, we also have decided that we will be taking some classes for you on research methodology. Okay? That again, madam will explain in detail. But the fact is that research methodology ke bhi alag alag types hote hain. Okay, which means when Priya ma'am or maybe when Meenal ma'am would take, they will give more the philosophical research pattern. If somebody takes from, let's say, some other teacher would take, a history teacher, she may take it from a different dimension. So just to tell you, we are also going to have one lecture of yours or maybe two lecture of yours in IIT Bombay, where Mahaka research pattern aapko dikhega. But remember one thing, they will be guiding you more from a scientific research because unka strength alag hai. We would do it from a different perspective. So we'll be having different ways of actually looking at the research methodologies. But the fact is that our research methodology has to be a combination or different from them. Other important thing, every particular project will have one, I would say, mentor guide. And that, interestingly, will be only one from the university. Remember last time we had said Divya had need to have somebody from there. It is not that. So we are tentatively saying that there will be teachers who will be part of your project as leaders and mentors to help you and guide you step by stage. And those are basically Seema madam herself has decided to be part of the thing. Then I'll be there. Murdul sir will be there. Priya ma'am. Then we have Sahita ma'am, Srini sir, then we have Sanjay Narayan sir, he's okay. So what we'll be doing is that depending on the teacher's availability, okay, we'll be saying that ek teacher ke saath 4-5 students rahenge. So they will be only giving you guidance. Now coming back, I just discussed the university pattern for the projects. Number one, you have to do 10 hours of project work every week. 10 hours of project work. You have to decide where to do that project. You can come and sit here and also do the reading, that is all not a problem. But according to the pattern is 10 hours. So you dedicate one full day of 10 hours according to your thing, or maybe split into 2 hours. You can decide that. 10 hours and reporting once in 15 days. Okay? That's the pattern. Once in 15 days मतलब आपको टीचर के साथ हफ्ते में एक बार या दो बार या दो हफ्ते में एक बार you have to be in touch with the teacher to get the guidance from time to time. Okay? So two things, once you decide your topic, and of course after madam gives the whole guidelines, you need to be working on a project wherever you are. You can work in the university also, but you need to be in touch with the teacher, and finally जब 100 marks होगा, those particular teachers, your guide will be approving, and then the 100 marks will be given to you. ठीक है, एनी क्वेश्चन ऑन द पर्टिकुलर रूल्स एंड ऑल थिंग्स लाइक दैट अपार्ट फ्रॉम द टॉपिक. ओके, व्हाट वी विल डू दैट आई विल रिक्वेस्ट मैडम टू गिव द गाइडलाइंस ऑन द प्रोजेक्ट बिकॉज शी इज द स्टार्वर्ड पर्सन, एंड सिंस प्रिया मैम इज ऑल्सो हेल्पिंग आउट इन द रिसर्च वर्ल्ड, ऑल थ्री ऑफ अस विल बी देयर टू हैंड होल्ड यू इन द प्रोजेक्ट्स. ठीक है, सो लेट मी रिक्वेस्ट मैम टू एक्चुअली गिव अस सम गाइडलाइंस.
I decided to speak last. Anyway. I wanted to get a feedback from the students also. So first of all, these two papers that you are going to do interdisciplinary and for skill-based and ability building. Paper one, that is logic. That will be very, very helpful for decision making, for methodology. And if you really want, if you are interested, you can do something from symbolic logic also. But symbolic logic, since it's an advanced course and you have not done logic so far, therefore we decided not to introduce symbolic logic initially, but introduce Indian and Western logic. But if you are interested and you want, then symbolic logic also can be, few lectures can be arranged, no examination of course, but logic is something which will be of a help to you. Another is of course communication, and Professor Sanjay Ranade thinks in a very different way. You know, he is a person who is a very creative person, and he doesn't go by stereotype manners. The syllabus which he has created in a very innovative way, and I'm sure that you will enjoy learning this particular paper also. Regarding the project work, you know, this is a very golden opportunity. Don't look at it as a burden. Don't look at it as you are going to do a PhD or a mini PhD. Don't look at the bulk which you have to produce. Forget about the bulk, but enjoy the entire process and look at it as an opportunity. It's an opportunity because whatever you have learned so far, it's all theoretical. Now, unlike any management course, we never had the field visits frequent, and we had not asked you to do your case studies and all those things. Here is one opportunity where you will see the applicability of your learned material. So you will have to decide that what you are planning to do in future, and whatever will be useful for future, you select the topic as your project work. You are free to decide whether you want to apply it in your own company, in your own field. Those who are not working and those who have aspiration for being political career, for them, again see whether you can apply these principles to start from the grassroots level and whether you can build your leadership. You know, writing a dissertation and getting through the examination in a way is easy, in a way. But this should not be just the goal of yours. You should be able to contribute something to your own self, your own personality, your own development, your own company, your own future, and automatically you will be contributing to the field of knowledge. Because after all, creativity in the field of knowledge is very, very important. The whole idea is that if we have 30 students here in the class, then all the 30 students in the class should give us some original contribution to the field of knowledge, and which will be also a guideline for the next batch as a case study. Therefore, think very thoughtfully. We think always thoughtfully. But you know, think about the future of yours, your career, and then how are you going to utilize it later on? Now, once you start thinking in this direction, you will think about various areas and dimensions. Now, one part we are still not clear about is how much length of this project should be. We are trying to get the clarification. We are trying to arrange for the meeting of the Board of Studies also. You know, in between the elections were declared, and therefore all the bodies of the universities were tentatively suspended, and therefore nothing could be done about the Board of Studies also. But we are trying to have at least one meeting of the Board of Studies where the decision can be taken that how it should be, really how much length for 100 marks, because there is no uniformity still at the university. Now, this is not a problem to worry about. By the time you will halfway through, we will definitely communicate to you that how much will be the length of 100 marks. Whether it will be 25 pages or 30 pages or 40 pages or 50 pages. Pages don't count, please. We are not going to weigh your project work. We are going to assess it academically. Because this is a very important question usually students ask. Madam, kitne panne hone chahiye? So, that's why I said we are not going to be. You know, Dr. Kamala Soni, PhD student in nutrition, food nutrition, and her PhD dissertation was 7 pages. 7 pages. She submitted it abroad. It was so original that all the foreign universities were not willing to allow her to come to India. My point is 7 pages. My point is, but don't write 7 pages. There is a reason. Not all of us are Kamala Soni. So my professor always used to say that writing a project is like 90% of perspiration, but 10% of inspiration. Look for those 10% of inspiration. But this is a bottom liner. This is not the end of it. If it's the other way around, I'll be very happy. So 50% of inspiration and 50% of perspiration will be the ideal thing. Now, what is perspiration? It means that going to the library, finding out the references, finding books, materials, consulting people, interviewing people, forming the data if required. Now, the methodology, if it is empirical methodology, you can use questionnaire, you can use interview method, you can get help of the statistical analysis where you can do the quantitative, and then on that basis you can construct and reconstruct, which will be like the hermeneutical exercise. The application part, you can be predictive about the future, but being predictive about the future, you must have some full foundation in the present. So these are the guidelines for you. Now, we don't want projects in the same domain. All of you are working in diverse fields, and therefore we have deliberately said that you can contribute to your own field and you can evaluate and you can give it to us. We are more interested in getting this applicability. Quantitative analysis for you will be important. If you want any help for quantitative analysis, let us know. We can arrange for lectures for quantitative analysis. But I think in decision making, you might have done some quantitative analysis. Otherwise, Seema madam will be good to give you guidelines for quantitative analysis. She's basically from mathematics statistics. So all that you will have to do is, first you will have to formulate a hypothesis. Hypothesis formulation is very, very important, because it is in the light of the hypothesis formed you decide your later journey. So you first decide the hypothesis. Having decided the hypothesis, you will also think about the research methodology which you are going to use. Empirical method, of course, you will use if it is required. A quantitative interview and questionnaire and quantitative analysis and all those data collection, if required, don't hesitate to use it. And of course, the qualitative, that is using the library, using the journals. Now that will be your responsibility. You will be selecting the topic. You will be framing the hypothesis. Related to hypothesis, to prove your hypothesis, you will have to collect the material from the library. Don't only depend on the library of the University of Mumbai. Use the library, Asiatic Society, use the library of any management institute available to you. If you require any letter to that effect, our department will give you the letter. Visiting libraries and reading books is another very, very important thing which will add to your perspective, to your personality, to your understanding, and to your decision making also. So look at this as an opportunity. So these, as Radha sir told you, that the 10 hours of working expected from you will include not only data collection, observation, experimentation, whatever, but visit to the library also. And you will keep record of all this, so that when you will meet your mentor, everything will be with you, and you will tell the mentor that this is what you have done. It should not be a goof of thing. I don't want to receive reports by the end of the first month or the second month that student so and so has not done any progress. You will be the loser. Keep in mind that there is a lot of difference between writing a 3 hours paper or a 2.5 hours paper and doing a project work. Don't keep on postponing your work from today to tomorrow. A day gone is gone forever. And this is very true for a project. I've seen students, those who don't work seriously, by the end of fourth year also, they are not able to write even 2 chapters of their research work. So please don't do that. Time at our disposal is not even 6 months. It's 3 months only. Keep it in mind. At the most, you may get extension for 15 days more. You all are working students. Your schedules are very busy. In spite of that, you will have to take time for this particular thing. I know this is going to be taxing, but this is going to be beneficial. This will add to your scholarship, and therefore without doing any delay, start thinking about it, because by the time you will be able to locate the problem and then discuss it with the teacher and then formulate a hypothesis, I'm sure that another 8 or 10 days will go. After that, you will have to work with a speed, but it doesn't mean that you have to work mechanically. No. We don't expect any mechanical reports. That we usually get in our answer sheets. You do it mechanically and then you produce it. This is your real examination. But this will be helpful also. I'm not telling you to frighten you, but I'm telling this you to encourage you. Do it and you will enjoy it. Learn to enjoy the entire process of writing a project. And this is not even a mini PhD. It's a very mini PhD, because for a PhD 4 years time is allotted. You are given only 3 months. So we don't expect something that you come out with 100 pages or 200 pages. I think at the most 50 pages will do. But again, let me tell you, pages is not important. You may write few pages more, you may write few pages less, but you should be pretty sure that what you have done is original and it is based on certain evidences and certain works. Think about the areas in which you want to work for future. Then take out a list of persons, scholars as well as others, not be available in the libraries, and this will be uniquely yours. And then, if possible, create some case studies and include in your project work some case studies. That also will be unique. Now, again, in your decision making paper, you are told how to create case studies and how to study. If not, again, Seema Madam will help you. Even Shrini sir also will help you, because they are good at building case studies and creating case studies and studying and all those things. Then it comes to the construction and supporting your hypothesis. Then you can constantly meet your mentor and then find out. This is again rough. You are given full freedom to do the work the way you want. But the end result should be completion of your project with a research methodology within 3 months, and you should submit it to us. So, important line is your research work will be on the application of what you have learned here. Decide any area, decide any topic, and then you do it. So that would be first. The methodology which you are using, you should be clear about. And then, what tentatively you are going to write. Before 1 month, if you get at least a skeleton work, what you are going to write, that will be the ideal thing. So you don't have to really worry about it. But if you are not able to, then at least see to it that before 15 days, the entire skeleton and rough work should be done. There is one more method. If you are using computers, you can create different folders in computers like cards. You know, when I was the student and when computers were not frequently used, we used to prepare cards, and they are very, very useful and handy rather than even printing things in computer. Because you have to search the file, you have to open that, sometimes it may get spoiled. Cards are long, durable things. You get research cards even today in any of the general stores which supply notebooks and all other things. Research cards, rather thick they are, and therefore they have that long duration thing. Over years, they remain with us. It's very simple to handle the cards, and you can select one particular point and enter on that card. Buy such cards, and for lifelong the cards will be with you. If you are happy with your note, or if you are with your computer, or even your smartphone, that also is alright. My point is that every time you come across something, you get a data, don't forget to record that data. Recording of the data is very, very important, because man's memory is notoriously short. After 2 days, you may not remember all 100% things whichever you have learned or read or have conversation with. And therefore, the moment you listen, the moment you have the conversation, so the moment you learn my lecture, you can see the recording and you can write it. But the best thing to train your memory is, don't listen to the recording, write down the points. And then again go back to the recording and find out how many points you have missed. This is very important. You know, man's brain has tremendous capacity. Use it. Rely on machines is all right, but less be dependent on machines. But that's your choice. I'm old-fashioned, and therefore I will tell you, use your brain more. But that's ultimately very, very beneficial. One thing is that once you prepare the cards, please try to introduce some order, discipline, or system in the cards. Make the boxes. Boxes doesn't mean that you have to purchase some wooden boxes, but boxes, they can be mental boxes, or they can be even cardboard boxes if you want actual. When you frame a hypothesis, in the light of hypothesis, when you go on, if you feel like modifying the hypothesis, don't hesitate. in modifying the hypothesis. Because hypotheses are meant for rejection and modification. Don't stick to the hypothesis. But if you feel like sticking to the hypothesis and if you go on getting the evidence, then do it. But again, let me tell you, all this is a very, very generic, very, very general guideline. You are free to develop your own model, module, whatever it is. You have freedom to select the topic, everything. But after 8 days, when we meet again, next Saturday, you must have your topic with you. Before that, if you feel like meeting any teacher, or even that Saturday, what we will do is, we will have all the teachers of semester 3 sitting together in one room. You can come one by one, you can discuss the topic, and we will decide that with whom you will work. You also are free to suggest, but we also will, because we don't want any particular teacher to burden. Now what? Again I suggest, then and there we may not take the decision, you may suggest us, you may write it on the piece of paper, your preferences of the mentors and the topic which you have selected. We will discuss about the topic. If we find that a particular mentor is overbooked, then we will think it amongst ourselves and we will redistribute that. We will not communicate it to you then and there. We will communicate it to you later. Now, this is how it is drafted. Keep in mind one thing. It is very different from writing 2.5 hours answer paper. Now you are all by yourself. Of course, you are free to take help of each other, no problem. But I don't want any project repeated. I don't want the same project done by two people. I want 30 independent different projects done. We are going to preserve it with us. We are going to preserve with us as the case study. So for us, these are very important documents. For you also, it should be a very important document. It should be giving you a guideline for your future. Take it very, very seriously, but don't take the burden. Very seriously doesn't mean that you think of running away from it. No. Accept the challenge, because you have already covered all the three semesters. And we know that you are capable. We know that you can do it. But only thing is that the method will be different. So be familiar with the method right from the beginning. No laziness. Don't postpone it to tomorrow. Decide that every day you will prepare minimum 10 cards, 20 cards, 30 cards, so that by the end of the first month your cards should be ready. Now look, constantly look at the time at your disposal and reschedule your timetable. Just as initially we told you how to write a paper within 3 hours, 4 questions or 5 questions, 5 hours, then 3 hours, distribute the timings and then write. The same principle applies here. If it is to be done within 3 months, it is to be done within 3 months. And if it is 3 months, then you have to decide how many hours you are going to work every day. If you do it systematically, then you will not feel the burden, you will definitely enjoy the process. So all the best to you. Think about the topics, think about the mentors, and next Saturday we will meet. But before that, I request Dr. Priya to tell you something about, because she has been in the process. Not only that she has done her PhD that everyone of here we have done, but she had submitted even the project works for a postdoctoral dissertation. She was also constantly thinking about one project or another to add on to her knowledge, and therefore she knows how to even prepare a project for a particular time slot. It's not for 4 years, but it's say for 3 months, 2 months, 1 month. So, Priya.
Since I recently submitted my postdoctoral dissertation, I will share some tips how I did it and on what are the secrets, and perhaps it may work for you. The most important thing all of us have, we don't have time. So I also had this problem that how will I complete it? And I recollect Joshi ma'am once had said, when I was doing my PhD, she had said that you have to constantly take your work with you anywhere you go. So I had kept that in my mind, and what I did was keeping my research topic in my mind, keeping a notebook in the bag. So whenever I was held up for a meeting, the meeting got delayed, or I was traveling and I was in traffic, I don't recollect missing that time. So sometimes I also use the smartphone where you can just type and you email yourself. So every day, your day should be divided into three aspects: reading, writing and reflection. Reflection should be throughout. Reading, what you have to read. In a week you have to plan actually, because this reading will not start right away. It will start when you start doing your research work. But of course, what are the important references you are going to be reading? And writing. Yes, writing can be a boring exercise for most of us. But writing, if you want to just know yourself, today itself, write on a piece of paper what is your dissertation topic. Just write. So you have a freedom to tear it. You have a freedom to file it. You have a freedom to show it to someone. But my experience is the minute you start writing, a lot of clarity comes on the paper. And that is what you do with brainstorming. So as ma'am said and as sir said, that at the end of the week, of course there will be a clear picture on that. Those pages will not be waste. Third important thing, as you're interacting in your office with different people, with different ideas, your workplace, that also is not something isolated from what you're doing here. The problem is we think research is something we will do after work or after 15 days. I think every minute there is something to do research on. There are many questions which are, there are many people with different ideas. The only thing is, are you active when you are at your workplace, when you are traveling? Ideas don't wait, they just come. So when they come, you have to gracefully take it, capture it and do something with it. And once you start having this kind of a habit of reflections and writing and reading, you will definitely start coming up with something concrete. And that's why, as ma'am said, strictly keep some specific time to sit and write. And whatever over, see, so many hours when you are with your work and with different people, you're actually gathered some information. So if you start doing this experiment, this work for me, it may work for you. See that in 1 month's time, whether whatever you are reading, writing, reflecting is contributing to the research which you are going to do. Second important thing I would also like to say, that different research papers which are there in your area, some good papers are there which are cited, please read them. Because now you have access to all the universities, different papers are there. Please read at least 2 to 3 papers till the next weekend, so that you get a direction. Third, you may like an idea which is stated in that paper, but research is all about taking that idea forward. So there is a temptation always of the lower mind, take that idea and repeat it, because nobody else has seen the paper. But you have to not get this, you know, you just have to go beyond. So you may take an idea, but go beyond. So if you start doing that, I think you will get a pattern of thought. And try to do some kind of unique research that after 2 years, 3 years, when you look back, you should be happy about it. It is not just as all of us know, it's not a routine thing. You should, because you all have that capacity to do something different. Now the path will be tough. If you want to achieve, it will be tough. And if it is tough only, then you will start working hard. So if you're ready to take that challenge, take from me, you will give something meaningful to the world in which you are. And the best quality work which you read today is a lot of effort has taken place. space in that process. So as we are trying to look at all of you, not just as MA students, but you are going to be the path breakers in the future in your own fields. And you have your own workplace where you can explore and experiment. And you know, you feel so nice when you will do that. You will yourself feel very, it will be a very enriching experience. So the more you start doing it with that dedication, you will get more than what you had probably imagined. So get into this habit of reading, writing, reflection, and maybe we will also take one session where we will also learn something from your research experiences. And let it be that your research should not be very limited, focusing only on India or only talking about the Indian dimension. But in that process, look at the global picture also. Where is the world? Why do we want to do research? See, research comes when you're disturbed by some questions. And I want to point out that 3 semesters, when you listen to many of the teachers, there were many questions which came to your mind. You liked something about that particular topic. There were some questions you wanted to know. I think from there, you can take the thread forward for your research. You have to get back, if you have made some notes, look at it, or some questions have remained with you. Those questions which have disturbed you, I think some of those will give you some dimension for your research. So, wish you all the best for this.
Thank you.
Thank you, Priya ma'am. I think immediately recollected my first opportunity to actually do some research. And as madam, she used to guide me for PhD, and as she very beautifully pointed out, it's not mini PhD, it's mini PhD. So I'll go back to one of the instances where I had no idea of how to write a research work, but I had gone to Kerala where I had studied the Arthashastra. And Dr. Gangadhar and I, many of you met him during the ICPA seminar. I studied everything, I used to make notes. But at the end of it, jaane se pehle kya sikha jab likh ke jao. So whatever you learn, please write it down and write it as a research work. To be very frank, I was not prepared. I did not know what is the meaning of research work because I did not have an academic bent of mind in research. But then ek baar guru ne bola hai, toh karna hi padega. So I asked him, sir, to be very frank, I don't know the process. If you can guide me, I will do it. I'm not telling you I will not do it. And what he did immediately, he said that I used to be studying at the Chinmay International Foundation in Kerala. He said, read some books on research methodology. That's the only tip he gave. Yeah. I went over there, I found 3-4 books from different scholars, different types of researchers. I read and I started making notes. Then I said, okay, this is how research methodology is. Then I read some research papers. You know, and then I came to know, okay, this is what the research world is all about. This is how they write, how they guide. And then what was interesting is that all the research that I have on Arthashastra, I actually just connected it. Okay? The thing is that I read this, I connected it, and by God's grace, what a writing ka habit tha, to likha, and I gave it to my guide and saying that, sir, I don't know whether it's right or wrong, I'll dekh lo. Yeah, I will say it. And immediately, I remember he gave me 9.2 out of 10. Now the thing is that basically, it was, according to him, very good work. The reason was two. It is not about 9.2 or 10. Every time I used to attend some lectures, I used to think, as Priya ma'am said, you know, this ka application kaise ho sakta hai. For example, when I read the 6000 sutras and he was telling, you know, Chanakya says about Amartya Utpatti. So I immediately start thinking, Amartya Utpatti means if I have to apply in my business, I need to have a manager, right? So somewhere I used to make that note. My notebook was always full. I never made that notebook for writing a research paper. I wrote that notebook for my own personal notes. So by the time the notes were ready, it was very easy for me to just connect it and make it a format. In fact, what I can do is that I can share that also if you want it. And the paper that came out was actually called Management Fundamentals in Kautilya's Arthashastra. That because I was in the field of management. And the Chinmay International Foundation actually published it on their website. And the Times of India people read it. And they called me up one day and said, we read your research paper. I said, which research paper? Oh, but they said, no, you come. And that's how they saw, and they said, can you write as a columnist for the Times of India group? And then based on that research paper, I almost wrote 175 articles in Times of India. Now, why am I telling you this? It connected me that when we are doing a PhD, for me, that whole thing, when madam used to, you know, take any particular sessions for guiding us, then she made make notes. And as ma'am said, you know, note keeping is not this video. Don't be dependent on Hosek or Meena to tell upload work anywhere, or not only during exam times. As she said, the notes kitna bhi chota ho, likho, likho, likho. Later on you can decide. Now one of the methods madam rightly pointed out is the research cards. It's a physical way of making notes. So what is a research card? You can go and buy the stationery shop very available. It's small, small. Instead of a full page, it's thick pages where if you get an idea, you make that note and keep it. Aisa ek samjho hafte mein aapke bag mein rakh dena. Then after 1 week, suddenly you have 25 cards, right? And you can sort it also. Saying that ye pehla idea, then you can write a paper. So there are different methods, mobile pe ho sakta hai. I think Rajesh Joshi, you have that note keeping software.
One note.
I don't know how many of you using. So that's an upgraded one. Actually, it started with the research notes. We have a software
you
format.
You can voice record also.
Voice record. But yes. notes, banana words are only. Okay? So with that, I think we will leave the time for you to think. What you want to go? What you have written as project, usko abhi chhod do. Where you want to apply it, what you want to study. I think by next week when you come back, we should be having that clarity on that. Theek hai?
Sure.
Any questions?
Hypothesis.
What is the meaning of hypothesis?
Yes. What will you do in this?
What is
hypothesis? Hypothesis is a tentative explanation or a tentative proposition which we want to establish. So what is that which we want to achieve?
For example, if you could explain this hypothesis with an example.
See, for example, you want to say that particular sutra of Chanakya, Kaudilyartha Shastra, is applicable to particular field of yours. Just as Radha said that he used it for management. Now initially that was his hypothesis, that it will be useful. He put it as a theory. Now that was appreciated by others and others started using it. But for you, you can take up a particular sutra or a principle or even anything from your syllabus. Maybe something from decision making or something from political leadership. And you may frame a hypothesis saying that this is what I want to see as a best application or a best practice in my domain. And then you start collecting the data. Now you can suggest me your field and your possible hypothesis.
Okay, let me give a simple example, not connected to our field. Okay? One of the medical doctors told me that's how they do research. Now, this is a very old school of thought. During that generation, there was a problem. Let's say, leprosy was a major disease. Remember that? Okay, so it's a proper medical doctor. And he says leprosy is a worldwide phenomenon. India maybe, all those things he studied. But he went to Germany, okay, and he did his PhD and came back. And then he says, now I want to understand how to apply my knowledge of whatever I have studied in Germany in Indian context. But his field was very clear that I want to solve the problem of leprosy in India. That clarity is what I want. So the first stage is basically having a clarity, what is the kind of a project you people want to do. That field has to be clear. और आपका अभी पढ़ाई भी हो गया डिसीजन मेकिंग साइंस अर्थशास्त्र ऑल दोस बट वेयर टू अप्लाई इज वेयर यू नीड टू डिसाइड क्लियर सो ही डिसाइडेड माय नॉलेज आई वुड अप्लाई इन इंडिया बट देन ही सेड ऑल दैट आई गॉट इन जर्मनी आई नीड टू टेस्ट इट इन इंडिया राइट सो व्हाट ही सेड इज दैट फॉर एग्जांपल माय ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू सॉल्व लेप्रसी इन इंडिया आई हैव गॉट सम थ्योरी बेस Then he says, my hypothesis is a kind of a tentative application. Saying that?
Tentative explanation.
Explanation. Saying that it can.
It is either confirmed or rejected in the light of further evidences collected.
Yes. So he says, ki leprosy ka Ayurveda mein bhi solution hai. Okay, that's a hypothesis. Sach hai ki nahi pata. हो भी सकता है ना, बिकॉज दिस इज वेरी इमोशनल फीलिंग समटाइम, यू नो इट कैन सॉल्व, बट देन रिसर्च वर्क इज नॉट इज इमोशनल फीलिंग, इट हैज टू बी वेरीफाइड, राइट? सो वॉट ही डज देन ही गोज एंड स्टडीज, एक्चुअली द आयुर्वेदिक नॉलेज, गोज टू सम आयुर्वेदिक एक्सपर्ट्स, टॉक्स टू देम एंड फाइंड इज दैट लेप्रेसी ऐसा है, डू यू थिंक, आई थिंक, आई फील, आई हर्ड, आई हैव रेड, देन ही सेज यस देयर इज, लेट्स वेरीफाई, देन ही विल टेक सम सैंपल ऑफ सम लेप्रेसी पेशेंट्स and then he puts it and finds out, wow, and every time he's doing it, he's making notes, huh? Aisa nahi ki baad mein dekhte hain. And then he quantitatively did it, he made a sample and he found out a solution for it, and then he rejected. So then the hypothesis is before you start, and the end result is verifying.
Let me also clarify this way. You know, many times the investigation of a crime, how is it done? Investigation of a crime, it doesn't have any clue as such. And the police officers, they initially form some hypothesis. Form hypothesis, it means that initially they collect the evidences and then they say, yeah, aisa aisa ho sakta hai.
Ye chor ho sakta hai, ye murder ho sakta.
Suppose it's a robbery, suppose it's a murder, suppose it's a kidnap. All the evidences, having gone through the evidences, then it is decided initially. That is a conclusion, but that is a conclusion without any support, without any evidences. But in the light of that, the further investigation takes place. So, how is it that the investigation continues, or the investigation, the police officers go on collecting the data in the light of the first framed hypothesis? They take someone in the custody, interrogate, and then they find that the person whom they have taken into custody is not at all guilty. It's someone else. So they release that person. Then they go to someone else. In the meanwhile, they go to the actual place where this entire thing, the crime has happened. Whether it is robbery or whether it is murder or whether it is kidnap. And then they go on collecting additional data. And in the light of that, they either modify the hypothesis or support the hypothesis. Now you must be seeing all those cases of crime solving on Sony and all those
CID, crime patrol.
Now, I used to explain my inter-art students when I used to teach them hypothesis. I used to collect such stories of actual crime solving where the investigation was taking place by police officers. A very interesting story, but I'm not going to tell you the story. How a hypothesis is framed and how framing of a hypothesis is very, very important, and creativity is required. You know, many Israelis were killed in the Second World War in Germany, and it was one of the colleagues working with Hitler who escaped the trials which were conducted after the end of the Second World War. And he disappeared, but he was alive. And he was the one who persecuted and killed the Jews maximum. And by then, Israel has become an independent nation. And the Israel government was very firm to find out that person. And they were putting hypotheses and finding out whether any clue they can get to find out this person, who was a colleague of Hitler. His name was Himmler. For 18 long years, the person was secretly living in Argentina. And after 18 long years, you know, look at the patients. They went on modifying their hypothesis because it was all guesswork, tentative. But they continued. And with one small thing, which the clue they got, with that clue, they constructed on it. Then actually they got that evidence. And of course it was like raw, their spies were there and they were, but it was building up a hypothesis, rejecting the hypothesis 18 long years. And then finally the hypothesis was confirmed when they found some written document in the house of that particular person They collected that and they found that handwriting matches. They picked that person secretly. They took that person to Israel, and then the trial was run and he was executed. Very, very interesting. Now, what is interesting is how many hypotheses were formulated and then rejected, and the new hypothesis formed, evidences collected and rejected. Now, it's all application. When it comes to application, we have to find out the tentative explanation, find out its applicability, whether it works. If it doesn't work, then we have to give the another explanation. And that's why I'm not giving you very concrete example, I'm just giving you the outline because I want you to decide your own areas. Say for example, if he decides to apply it in his bank, one experiment he has already done it. You know, instead of me, he said we, and he got the proof for it. But that is just a part of it. So similarly, what you can do is, now initially that was his hypothesis. He thought that, let me see whether it works. And then he, all the stages, he approached his authorities, and then he consulted, and then he convinced his team members, and then he chalked out the policies, then actually the application of the policies, and finally he got his hypothesis confirmed. This is what a hypothesis is. You know, you start with something. You know, when we are trying a recipe, we say, let us see the modification in the recipe. Instead of this, let us try this, a hypothesis. If it turns out to be good, hypothesis is confirmed. If it doesn't, next time we are not going to repeat it. So simple as that. Workability of our own theory is what is hypothesis. So see the workability, try, collect the data. If you don't see that it is working, put it aside. But don't give up so easily. So framing of a hypothesis also is a very crucial stage. It use your creativity, but use also the data which is around you. Now you can analyze, on what grounds did you feel that it's not we but we that will help? You may not explain to us, but you may share it with your students, your friends, your colleagues. Now we come to certain tentative explanations in our day-to-day life also many times. And we find out whether it works, we reject it. If it doesn't, if it works, we feel happy. We use it, but only thing is that we are not aware because we use it only for the time, short period of time. Here we are going to use it for 3 months. We are going to collect it and we are going to put it, a theory put into practice for minimum. Remember, I gave you that formula. It's not just the theory, but it's a praxis which is important because it is the praxis which brings the transformation. Had this distinction between me and we remained on the paper, it would not have been a praxis. It became praxis. We felt nice about it. And we shared it with so many people. I shared it with at least 100 people saying that here is the evidence. Why not we change from me and mine and me and mine, because constantly we talk in philosophy, forget about ego, forget about ahankara. But when it comes to competition, we run with the wings of me and mine and me and mine. So we have to make the change. So we are the trendsetters for future. Don't hesitate to bring the change. And that is the strength of yours. So think originally when you frame the hypothesis. And that's why I said, use the knowledge which you have used.
Which books we should refer for research methodology?
Research methodology. We'll give you the next time list. We'll give you next time. I'll consult all the teachers also, because especially decision making. We are going to arrange some lectures on research methodology, but it's a good question. Next time when you come, we will collect, because almost all MPhil courses have their list of research methodology papers.
Yes. There's one thing.
Yeah.
There's a book by John Best.
John
Best.
How is it
called? B-E-S-T. Best.
John Best.
John Best. On research methodology. It's a good book. Lokeshkaur. LOKESHKAUL. Lokeshkaur.
KAUL. You go to the library and enter research methodology, you will get n number of books.
This is where actually your research work starts. You know, university is meant for research. We are becoming only
examiners. Just keep in mind one thing. Research methodology, quantitative research methodology is slightly different. Qualitative research methodology is slightly different. So, when you frame the hypothesis, but there will be some generic books on research methodology. So, start with general books on research methodology. Priya Madam has suggested a book, General Research Methodology, where all these steps will be foundations of this kind of hypothesis and confirmation of hypothesis. This will be very useful for them.
But that is like
very, very elementary, I know.
Years back, so that book.
Research methodology normally which we have learned is more from a scientific point of view.
And management standpoint.
How do I relate that to the philosophical point? Because we have learned
that Let me explain. We don't want a philosophical research.
Please understand.
We don't want a philosophical research. When I talk about application and when I talk about data collection and quantitative analysis, of course you are using scientific. Only thing is that your conducting of experiments will be different from that of laboratory.
Correct.
So I don't want any philosophical research here. And that's why you missed that point probably. You refer to the recording. I specifically said that quantitative analysis in your research is and if you want any guidance for quantitative analysis, we will have again Seema ma'am and
We take some lectures, as you said.
Yeah, yeah. So that is because, I'm just taking an example. Like, say one of the sutras of Chanakya relates to HR.
Okay.
That is a hypothesis.
Okay.
So then we will build on that hypothesis and say that, you know, then we should do research on that sutra and all those translations of that sutra. How does it relate to HR? And meet some people in HR, say
yes.
That do you work this, do you do this activity?
Yes.
And
collect those data.
Collect those data and
verify.
Is that understanding?
Perfect.
Actually, you should find a group on which you can
experiment your theory.
So then that group, then you use a quantitative method. So
I'll take this same example further. That's what I did. You know, Chanakya Saptanga model, right? Swami Amartya Durga Purushottam. So they said, okay, so Chanakya Saptanga, can we apply in business? Can we apply in the armed forces? Can be applied probably in the administration. So what happens? This becomes your theory applied. That's where the application comes. Remember the word application. Yeah.
I had presented a paper on value perception, which we presented at University of Patpoosha. So what we had done, we had developed a questionnaire, and we also took use of experts on that questionnaire. Nearly 10 people who looked at our questionnaire, and you know, we tried to develop it further. Then we had a pilot study on a smaller group and then on a larger group. So this becomes very interesting, and then you know, how to evaluate it, etc., becomes quite interesting. So whenever you're taking a particular sutra, making a particular problem, and if you want to quantify something, make it more criteria based. Make some pointers. For example, our study was on how do adolescents perceive values. So we had taken particular values and then we had made questions on that. So it is the quantifying process becomes very interesting. But as ma'am said, it may not always be quantitative, it can be qualitative, it can be both. As per your choice, it can work. Second important thing, there are many foreign universities where they give these free courses. You can just enroll. I would suggest enroll for these research methodology courses. You would learn something online and by the time you are doing this, you will complete it and you will get some more insight. There are wonderful online courses plus. Even in city of Mumbai, there are certain colleges who arrange workshops on SPSS. The software, and there are different other research initiatives which are taken. So, you know, you can focus on that as well.
Thank you.
That choice is yours. You have full freedom. You can deviate from whatever guidelines are given to you. Doesn't matter. I only want, we all, what we want is that some application of what you have learned in the course. This you will not deviate from. Rest of the things yours.
Maybe you can just complete that. We'll complete.
Instead of changing the hypothesis in between, can we reject another hypothesis and start an alternate hypothesis first too and then navigate?
That's up to you.
Yes, up to you.
Because ultimately what you are going to establish is the confirm.
So the topic that you may have deselect and hypothesis what we do. So from a project perspective, we need to close it within 3 months or 3.5 months. But if you want to do something beyond, after, like, you know, whatever is required for the project perspective, something more that you want to do or pursue in that, is there a scope of doing that also?
So now here is the beauty of it. You can do it lifelong also. Like for example, 7 pillars, abhi bhi kar raha hu, verify kar raha hu, ho raha hai ki nahi ho raha hai, usko. The thing is that you have to get to the academic discipline. Ye 3 mahine mein karta hai. Uska application refinement lifelong karta rahega. That's why after PhD also postdoctoral chal raha hai na. See, the thing is that it's a continuous journey, but you need to get a timeline into it. Varna kya ho jayega, mentally indisciplined ho jaoge na, fir aisa kitne logon ne project submit nahi kiya.
No, but that is what I said.
No, what I'm saying is that you don't have that mental discipline that you have to complete your time. Waisa ho jata. So to get now ki 3 mahine mein khatam hi karna.
That is what I said initially also, that this is going to be lifelong, it's beautiful. It's going to be life. That's what I said, that is going to contribute to your career. It's going to contribute to your future. But you have to finish it within 3 months. And then you can go on refining. So, and usually what happens, why the delay is done, usually we feel, ye kya hai, ye sara trash hai, ye kya hai. But don't do that. Keep in mind that 3 months. And therefore you may think that ye trash hai, but try to improve immediately. Don't postpone it. And whatever is there, then go through it and then try to finalize it. Ideal situation will be lifelong learning. But this is not ideal. Ideal situation for us, 3 months and submission of the project.
In fact, it is not 3 months. So,
three months.
But getting to that mental discipline, usi mein khatam hai.
And by the time, you know, all these are guidelines. You have full freedom to use your way. If you feel like, अरे क्या है hypothesis formulation की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है, ये topic मुझे दिख रहा है, I am going to work on it. Workability you should be able to establish. And please, all 30 people, please do it. I don't want any defaulters. This time, third semester, there are 4 defaulters, which is a very bad thing. No, I would have said that results will not be declared. Of course, results will not be declared unless the work is submitted. Please don't take this freedom.
You've taken it for granted.
You are paying through your nose. Some of them have not paid also. Pay the fees. This is a very, very important course and a precious course you are doing. You are already done 1 full year. For 1 full year, you have paid, you have toiled. Now don't leave it halfway through. You have to work. Otherwise we will feel bad about it. Do it. Do it as fast. We are not going to give you concession anymore.
No, no, it is not. They are failing anyways. I'm not going to take it for granted.
Give them some time to finish it. Otherwise it will be...
It's eternal. Kya chutti hai nahi hai? Kya inke paas time nahi hai? I can declare the name straight away, but that's an insult to those individuals. This is not done. How much time you can do? Feast pe bola theek hai, chalo samajh mein aa gaya. But you can't submit your projects on time, only the assignments on time, and no guilt feeling also. That is the worst. Anyway, that's a different thing. So what we'll do, we'll take a break right now. So all those people who want to leave can leave. But I want a few people to stay back for some internal discussion. And the research students, along with Pankti, you stay back because we've taken one common project. So I would request Alka started to come by now. Suhas, please stay back. Siddhi, please stay back. Amrish, okay, and Yuraj, who is here. Josefa, Santosh, Santosh Patani, Pramod, Pramod, please stay back. Farah, Amir, and Mukesh. And these people can just stay back. Others can take a break. They pass them as a break here. Anything else? You are here for something?
And one more thing which I wanted to share with
you.
In between, I had been to Sarnath, and I had fortune to present some philosophical thing in front of His Holiness Dalai Lama. It was the International Conference on Concept of Mind, and I spoke on. It was International Conference on Concept of Mind, and I spoke on Concept of Mind Sankhya. It's available on YouTube. The 2 days recording, full 2 days, it was a 2 day international seminar. Full 2 days international proceedings are available. My presentation is first day opening presentation. So if you are interested, you can have a look at it. Dalai Lama commented on it, and more than 1,000 people were there in the audience. And Sarnath is a deemed university for higher studies in Tibetan traditions. So they have study of Tibetan medicine, study of Tibetan philosophy, which means Tibetan type of Buddhism, and some other. They have 5 faculties. Management also, they have a faculty. Interesting part is that everybody working as a volunteer also was very attentively participating in that conference. And I spoke for 20 minutes, then there was question answer session. The Sankhya concept of mind is a very peculiar one. I don't know how many of you will be interested in it, but it's worth listening to. And very important is, even the photographer who was doing all that recording came to me and said, "Madam, I liked the presentation very much." It was not compliment for me, but it was the compliment that I presented it with simplicity. So,
where can we see that?
It's on YouTube. I'll pass it on to you. I'll give it to you. I'll pass it on to him, and he will give it on your own.
Thank you, so we'll see you all next week.
Yes,
sir. And we are available if you want to meet personally also, just give us a call. Make sure we are out.